Well, I've started off with great. My job was not to cry. and it failed as soon as she walked out there. Okay. Shannon, Allie, John, do you take Charlotte to join your family?
Absolutely.
Paul, Pearl, Robert, me. Do you take Patrick to join your family?
Absolutely.
We do. We do. Welcome, everyone, to the wedding of Charlotte Hewitt and Patrick O'Banion. We'd like to thank everyone who was able to make it out here today, those watching through the internet, and we'd like to remember those who cannot be here with us today. We wish you were here to see this beautiful ceremony. I've prepared a speech about Patrick and Charles. I'll be honest, I never thought of Charles getting married. It just never crossed my mind. What do you mean, married? She's still the goofy, curly top that played Spore and Pirates of the Caribbean online and all the other games with me, who would barge into my room, point at me and say, "Why are you the worst?" And then walk out without the slightest explanation. Of course, I did the exact same thing back. The goody two-shoes little sister who would always wake me up for school with the classic disappointed glance. My fellow space traveler on Space Mountain, pilot on Goofy's Barnstormer, or fellow Wild West cowboy on Thunder Mountain. Because, of course, rides at Disney were fun. But making worlds around those rides together, well, that made Disney magical for us. I feel so lucky to have had a sibling like Charles while growing up, and I feel sorry for only children. Sure, being the center of attention is great, but there's nothing quite like sitting upside down together watching SpongeBob or pulling every pillow from every room in the house and building the best fort you've ever seen. Besides, being the center of attention was never an issue for me, much to Charles's chagrin. There's a distinct lack of men in our family. Of the younger generation, I am one of two. So I am so excited to finally have a brother. Truth be told, Pat and I didn't always get along. He used to get on my nerves, to tell the truth. Sometimes I wanted to throttle him. I think about it now, looking back, and the way I felt was honestly how I felt about Charles most sometimes, whenever we had a fight or something like that. It felt like a sibling getting on your nerves. It took me a while to realize it, but Pat has always felt like a brother to me in the back of my mind. He just nestled right into the family. It was hard to accept anyone that would be good enough for Charles. That's just the protective older brother thing. But Pat loves my sister with everything he has and treats her like a goddess, and that's really all I could have ever hoped for. Plus, we Brits have Pat to thank for finally introducing us to the full joys of Thanksgiving. A few years back, Pat insisted we all needed to have a proper American Thanksgiving instead of our boring old turkey and veggies. And my God, my world was changed forever. I love nerding out about food with Pat for the past few Thanksgivings. It's become one of my favorite parts of the holiday season. We've been like little kids in a candy store coming up with dish ideas for the feast. I can't wait for all the feasts ahead. On a side note, it doesn't hurt that I get my own personal IT guy that I can call up for whatever issues I have with my computer. Even though I could probably have just Googled the answers, which you never failed to tell me many times. But thanks for always being patient and helping me through, even though it must be absolutely frustrating. Congratulations to both of you. I love you. I miss you all the time. Sorry I don't always answer my phone. I'm terrible about that. And I'm so happy I get to share tonight and tomorrow with you. Have a wonderful few days and an even better future. The bride and groom have elected to share their own private vows.
No pockets.
No.
Do you, Patrick O'Banion, take Charlotte to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Charlotte Hewitt, take Patrick to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Please bring up the rings. Charlotte, as you place the ring on Patrick's finger, please repeat after me. You cannot possess me, for I belong to myself.
You cannot possess me, for I belong to myself.
But while we both wish it,
but while we both wish it,
I give you that which is mine to give.
I give you that which is mine to give.
I pledge to you my living and my dying.
I pledge to you my living and my dying.
Each equally in your care.
Each equally in your care.
I shall be a shield for your back and you for mine.
I shall be a shield for your back and you for mine.
And honor you above all others.
And honor you above all others.
This is my wedding vow to you.
This is my wedding vow to you.
Our love is never ending, and we will remain forever equals in our marriage.
Our love is never ending, and we will remain forever equals in our marriage.
Patrick, as you place the ring on Charlotte's finger, please repeat after me. You cannot possess me, for I belong to myself.
You cannot possess me, for I belong to myself.
But while we both wish it.
But while we both wish it.
I give you that which is mine to give.
I give you that which is mine to give.
I pledge to you my living and my dying.
I pledge to you my living and my dying.
Each equally in your care.
Each equally in your care.
I shall be a shield for your back and you for mine.
I shall be a shield for your back and you for mine.
And honor you above all others.
And honor you above all others.
This is my wedding vow to you.
This is my wedding vow to you.
Our love is never ending, and we will remain forever equals in our marriage.
My love for you is never ending and will remain forever equals in our marriage.
By the power invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
She wants the dip.
Dip, dip, dip.
The veil.
Oh God! I said careful with the veil.
It was too loose, Angela. It was too loose.
All right. Hang on. It is my honor to present to you for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. O'Banion.